In this lesson, we will learn how to use the options bar. The options bar is located below the ribbon and appears gray and empty when no tool is active. On the contrary, when a tool is active, the options bar becomes a light green color, and there we can find several options related to the active tool. To get a better understanding of what I mean, I will activate the wall tool. Now, as you can see, a variety of options appear. On the left, there is a drop-down that determines if we will create a wall by defining its height or its depth. Simply put, if I select the height option, the wall will be created at the current level. Otherwise, it will be created underneath the current level. In this example, I will select the height option. Next to this drop-down, there is a value field. In this field, I can define the exact height or depth of the wall. So, I will type 4,000 since the project units are set to millimeters to define the wall's height. Apart from the drop-down menus and the value fields, there are also options that can be activated if you activate the corresponding checkboxes. In this example, such options are the chain option and the radius option. With the chain option active, you will create continuous wall segments, while the radius option creates filleted walls. It is a good practice to make the desired settings in the options bar before you start drawing. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention that depending on the active tool, the conditional tools in the options bar may differ